Hi guys, it's ShishkaBobber1 coming right back at you with another Boom Beach video. Today's video, guys, is a special guide for low-level warrior map clears. Warrior map clears with brick in particular. I will not be clearing my whole map today, though. I'm going over techniques. I'm going to try to cover all of the relevant bases, but undoubtedly I'm going to miss a few points here. That being said, it's still kind of an introductory guide, so maybe I'm going to hit too many. Brief overview of what we'll be talking about today. We'll be talking about warriors, we'll be talking about brick, we'll be talking about flares, mine clearing, we'll be going over the drop, all the different styles, we'll be talking about smoking, and we'll be talking about shocking. So this, to use warriors requires a pretty big skill set, especially when you're going to use them effectively. So I'm not going to try to spend too much time focusing on each skill set with excruciating detail, but I'm going to give enough detail to get you started off to your way to clearing your archipelago with style, with warriors and brick. Now, where to begin? So, well, first of all, this is my mini account. I run a main called ShishkaBobber. Most of you guys know that. I've been playing this game for a long time, 4 years. This is a bit of an anomaly for any low levels that might be watching this. As you can see, I have no defenses in this account. Don't worry about that. That's another video to explain the philosophy of how I upgrade what I do. The point is, it's a level 46 account, and I've got 829 DP. Might be a little bit higher than most of you guys, but good, because that'll just give you better examples to show you today on this video. So to begin, let's discuss our troops, the warriors, okay? We need to understand what they are, how they tick, and all that good stuff. So in the armory, you can find the warrior information. First of all, I should probably back up and say that this video applies to anybody that's level 32 and higher. You really need smokes to take advantage of it, and you don't get smokes till HQ 14, which happens at level 32. Okay, so if you're not 32, just save this video, watch it later. But yeah, so the warriors here. We know that they've got a pretty fair amount of health for their troop size. So they can take a couple of hits. They move very quickly for their movement speed, and their range is melee, which really puts them in the middle of damage, because since they have to be right on top of structures, that means there's a lot of defenses around them hitting them. As a result, though, they will actually be doing healing per hit. Now, every time they swing, well, this probably varies per warrior level, of course. Mine are max for my level, which is level 16. Your results will vary, but what you'll see is every time they swing, they heal themselves for 70 HP per hit. This is really nice. And the time between hits is 1 second. So that's 70 health per second that they're constantly getting back. As another note to this, you might also see that on the damage per hit, mine says 373 plus 160.39. That plus 160.39 is actually coming from my statues, guys. It's coming from my Troop Damage Masterpiece and my Troop Damage Guardian over here. So I've got 30% and 13, which gives me an extra 43% damage. So that's what you're seeing right there, in case you were wondering. And same thing with the health. I've also got extra troop health, and that's why you see the bonus. But the important thing about the damage that I wanted to get into, you see the troop damage modifies the damage per hit, but it does not modify the self-heal per hit. In fact, the only thing that does modify self-heal per hit, well, it's nothing, but what modifies HPS, health per second that you get back, is of course the time between hits. And there's one hero that can help us with that. And that, of course, is our friend Brick and her battle orders, guys. Sergeant Brick with her battle orders. And the reason, of course, as you know, is because you get a speed bonus, all right? So with my level 5 battle orders, I'm getting a 50% speed bonus. So they're swinging more quickly and healing themselves more quickly. But more importantly, they're doing more damage, okay? that's really why we like battle orders. It gives you the most bang for your buck. And there's also a damage bonus associated with battle orders while they're under the effect of it. And you'll get an extra 25% damage. So not only do you get speed, which increases your damage because you're swinging faster, and it increases your healing a little bit, you also get a damage bonus on top of that, which is really, really nice. Because with warrior hits, you're basically only alive as long as your shocks are. But we'll get into that. So the point is you want to get as much damage in as you can under the shock cycle. And that's where Brick and Battle Orders becomes your best choice, or my favorite choice, let's say. There's other options, guys. You know, you can use Kavan and Crystal Shield or Ice Shield. That works pretty well for Warriors. And then later on, when you get Bullet and Taunt, that works amazingly well with Warriors. But the focus on this video is Brick and Battle Orders. And Brick will still take down a base faster than Bullet, so she is your biggest DPS choice. Yeah, so I guess that's basically it, but there are some special considerations when using Brick because of where she stands, and that's kind of the topic of this video, is how we can maximize our usage of Brick with Warriors to get bases down. Okay, so we talked about Warriors, we talked about Brick, let's talk about flares, guys. There's basically two types of flares that we can use. We'll use Dr. T Stage 2 as a proving ground. But the two types of flares I'm referring to is either a ground flare, which you can just flare any point on the ground directly and your troops will path there, or there's a building flare. And you can see anytime you flare a building, it locks on. We'll do that again. Watch the HQ. You'll see it lock on. Anytime you see that lock mark, you know the building has been flared and not the ground. The consideration for this is how your troops move. Well, we have an active flare right now, so we need to wait for that to expire. Actually, I'll just drop my flare down here. Now watch this. If we get all of our troops out, and now if I flare the ground, they all run straight towards that point. Okay? Now, more or less, they go in straight lines. We'll talk about 45-degree padding some other day, but you see, they're all basically just converging at that one point, that one pixel. Now, if I flare a building, they're not converging on one point or one pixel. They're converging on a set of points or a set of pixels or tiles. I actually don't want to kill this base yet, but if you saw that, they were fanning out. That's because each warrior wants to stand around that building, and each warrior has their own position. One warrior might stand at 3 o'clock, one warrior might stand at 6 o'clock, whatever. So they already know, they're really quick. They already know internally, when once you flare on that, where each one is supposed to stand. So each warrior takes their own independent path to the point that they're going to end up on, all right? And this can be problematic when you're trying to keep them under smoke and things, because they fan out more with building flares. So I highly recommend the usage of ground flares. We'll do one more example of a ground flare approach versus a just a building approach. So if I did a ground flare approach, let's just drop all my warriors. Let's put a ground flare right by the HQ. Watch how more or less they're gonna converge to that point. They're all nice and tight, and they're gonna fan out and go around. They're gonna just kinda go everywhere. But let's bring them back here. Let's bring them back to the start. And then now, if we go back to the HQ, you're gonna see them fan out a bit. You see how they're fanning out? And it's more pronounced than other times, but the point is ground flares are a better way to move your warriors, and it's the way I'm gonna be showing you. But it's very counterintuitive to a lot of players, and it's not the first thing you do. Most players flare on buildings. But there are reasons ground flares will save you GDE, because you can use less smokes, because when your warriors are in smaller paths, you don't have to use as much smoke to cover a wider area. And you can actually save warrior lives because of it too. You can actually get more warriors to your target. But that's the basics of flares. You've got building flares and ground flares. There is a time for both though, don't get me wrong. I mean, you gotta flare the HQ to attack it, right? but, so we've covered flares. We know that we're gonna be primarily focusing on ground. Now, the next consideration is mine clearing, guys. And to get into mines, you know, there's three basic types of mines. Go back to the armory here. We've got your normal mines, which will do a small amount of damage. The mine are level 1, because I haven't upgraded these yet, but they do a small amount of damage in an area. And these can be problematic when you run over a few of them. It really depends on the level of the mine, so I do recommend that you inspect the level of the mine on the base that you're rolling on. Most of the players on my map are around level 65, so most of them have level 22 mines, and those hurt. Yeah, it's 296 damage for a level 22 mine, and going back to the warrior health, let's see here, up. Yeah, we're rocking 945 base health. So, you know, we can eat three of those and still stay alive, maybe four when you factor in our bonuses, but we're going to be hurting, and any other damage on top of that, the warriors start to worry. So, And keep in mind that one mine can hit a bunch of troops, and they can be problematic because we like to keep our troops close together. But in general, you can eat one or two mines and it's no big deal. That's the point. The mines that do hurt a lot, of course, are boom mines. These do a lot more damage. They have a much, much smaller area of effect if you hit them, so you maybe just lose one or two warriors when you're in over them. But in general, I do like to take out boom mines because I want all my warriors to get to the HQ, or as many as possible, because I need to do as much damage as possible. So we do like to primarily bart out boom mines, and by bart, I'm saying barrage and or artillery. It's a slang term that we use in the game, but bart stands for barrage and artillery. So some combination of barrage or artillery I like to use to get rid of boom mines. The only other type of mine that there is shock mines. Now, with shock mines, they don't really affect warriors that badly. It does depend on what level your smokes are. If you have very low-level smokes, it's possible that your smoke will expire before the duration of the shock mine. But in general, if your warriors hit a shock mine, they still move fast enough to get out of the harm's way by the time the smoke clears. But this does depend when you throw the smoke as well. Right. So, we don't really care about shock mines, that's the point. At least I won't when I'm doing it, because the way I smoke allows me to have enough time to counter them. And if you know you're going to hit a shock mine, it's a really good idea to throw a smoke right on that area the moment they hit the shock mine. That way they get the maximum time under the smoke. But we'll get to that too. This might be too advanced for some of the people watching this, but maybe not advanced enough. So I'm trying to hit a broad spectrum here. Excuse me, guys. Where were we? So, mine clearing. Yeah. So, now the thing with mine clearing is how to use the right combination of barrage and artillery to take down the mines. Now, let's take a look at this guy right here. This is a base I'll be attacking later on in this video. We're going to use him for a few examples. You can see that this guy has a bunch of mines on the way to the HQ. And you can also see... You also need to look for hidden mines a lot, guys. That's one thing that you gotta watch out for. Some buildings, like sniper towers, he's not doing it, but it's very easy to hide mines behind sniper towers. Oh, yeah, there's a mine hiding back there. You see it? There's one behind this sniper tower. And the corners of HQs, there's lots of places... Yeah, see, there's a boom mine. There's lots of places people like to hide mines, so you need to pay attention to that. In fact, if you see, we've got a boom mine on all three corners of the HQ right here, and there's just a normal mine up top, and then we got a bunch of mines down here. Now, when we attack it, of course, go ahead and hit attack. We're not going to do the full attack yet, but I want you to see GBE costs. So our barrage is 10, our artillery, well, I've got tribal artillery right now. Normally it's 3, but it doesn't matter. You gotta just go with the cost. We've got tribal reduction on artillery costs right now. That's why mine are cheaper. They're 50% cheaper than normal. But the point is this, I wanna basically have all three of those boom mines cleared around the HQ, and I wanna have a clear path to there. Now, what's the cheapest way to do it? Well, it's going to involve some combination of probably one barrage and a few artillery, all right? Now, I've got two choices. I can do a barrage down in this area where the cannon and sniper tower are to clear all of these mines, and then I can use artillery to take out the boom mines up here, or vice versa. I can use a barrage on the HQ area, and I can use artillery to take out mines down here. There's pros and cons to both. Honestly, I'm not even sure which one's the best to do on this. In general, when I'm not thinking about it, I like to do a barrage on the HQ. Now, the reason for this is because I like to get damage on the HQ. But really, it might not be the best. Okay, here's the first approach you can take. Let's just analyze both. Let's do it that way. If you put one barrage, and I'm trying to hit, you see, we've got a boom mine on the 9 o'clock corner, the 6 o'clock, and the 3 o'clock. I want to put my barrage on a point that's equal distant from them all in an attempt to try to hit them all. So I'm going to put my barrage right about there. And I think it took out the 6 o'clock boom mine. It definitely took out the 9 and the 3. Not sure. But now we're left with these other mines. Now the key with artillery is, remember, there's a one tile splash radius, guys. Now if I want to take out a mine just by itself, where the mine is sitting by itself, I could hit it like this, and boom, we take out the mine. But you can get more value. You can actually get up to 3 mines. Actually, you can get more than 3. You can probably get 9 mines with one artillery if they're positioned just right. But the point is, you can get one tile splash on either side. So, you see with these mines right up here, if I put my artillery on the second mine from the shore, right here, I'm going to get the one on the shore and that shock mine. And we got that lower level defense as well. So always use your artillery splash radius as to your advantage. Sometimes he doesn't have a good configuration. Well, yeah, he kind of does. You see these two mines right here by the sniper tower? One is at 10 o'clock and one is at 2 o'clock. One artillery should be able to get these. Now, these aren't really in my way so much, but I'm just showing you as an example. One artillery can nail both of those if you go right between it. You see that? You got to be able to look for these things when you're trying to take out mines. Now, let me just retreat, and let me show you probably what is the better way to do this one. Because keep in mind, guys, your barrage is doing damage to the HQ and your artilleries are. So in the first example, which I didn't even do completely, let's do that again. In the first example, I would do a clear something like this. I would have done a barrage here, and I would have gone like, what would I have done? I would have said artillery like, well, it kind of depends on the drop style, guys, but I might do something like artillery here, and then maybe one more here, because there's a double mine. I don't mind eating a few, because now we've got a consideration, like, sometimes artillery costs more, right now it's cheap, but my next artillery is 5, okay? Now I know that if my warriors are coming along here, they're going to eat these 3 mines, 1, 2, and 3, I can't select them, but you see those 3 mines? There's also the mine up here on the top of the HQ. So assuming these are level 22, I didn't check, but assuming they're level 22, that's about all I can eat. So I know by the time I get to the HQ, I'm already going to be throwing a medkit down. Because of that though, I don't need to waste another 5 GDE on an artillery because I'm just going to be recovering that health with a medkit anyway when I get there. So my point is, I would choose to eat that mine right now. I would not spend the extra artillery to clear another mine because I know I'm already planning to heal my troops when they get to the HQ. GDE management is important, and these are considerations you need to think about, but again, maybe too technical. But it all gets into knowing how much damage you can take. Alright, but those are the basics of mine clearing. Just try to center your barrage and look for the overlap. Use that one tile splash radius to your advantage on the artillery. And so that's the last point, I guess, would be barrage has a bit of a random nature to it. Or if you just slightly tap in a different spot than when you tap before, you can get different outcomes. Sometimes if you don't get a barrage that you like, it's worth retreating and trying again. Don't waste more GDE. When you don't have to, just retreat and start again. That's another key advice. There is some randomness associated with barrage, guys. Don't be afraid to retreat. It's okay. It's a lot cheaper to save that gold on a retreat. I mean, you spend the cost of the attack, which for me is 11k, versus losing all your troops. That can cost you a lot more gold, because if you run out of GDE and you don't have enough to shock, you've just lost all your troops, and that costs you a lot more. So don't be afraid to retreat. That's another good point of mine. That's enough about mine clearing, guys. Let's get into the drop. Okay, the drop refers to how you deploy your troops. Let's go back to Dr. T. Throat's getting scratchy. Alrighty. Now with the drop, what do we got here on my notes here? The first thing to discuss about is flags. Alright, flags, I'm assuming you're kind of familiar with this already, with these concepts. Flags work a lot like flares. Flags are what you get when you drop a troop down. You see, on the beach, I touched right there, and the warriors, they walk to the flag just like they would walk to a flare, and then they just go wherever the heck they want, right? But the cool thing about flags that you need to keep in mind that's slightly different than flares is that each boat gets its own flag. And that's the only time in the game that you can command boats independently. Otherwise, they are landing craft, I should say. Otherwise, they all follow flares. So this concept can be a bit useful, and we take advantage of it when we do our drops. Let's see. The first probably easiest style drop, and in fact, this base is not a good example for this. Let's go back to this guy. He's going to see a lot of attacks from us today, I think. So the easiest drop is what we kind of call like a reverse Mickey Mouse. or an upside-down Mickey Mouse, and this actually involves a building flare to the closest defense. This is the typical drop that most people start with on Warriors. Let's go into it. Now, I'm actually going to go ahead and clear the mines around this boom cannon, around this cannon, to show you. And so, a lot of people, I guess maybe the most basic drop. I gotta think way back. The most basic drop, people probably flare their structure, and you probably go like smoke and smoke, and you just drop everybody, right? You just spam it, and you put another smoke here, and then like another smoke like that. That sort of looks like a reverse Mickey Mouse or something. You get all your troops up there, bricks down here, everyone's happy, whatever. Now let's run away before we lose our troops. But that's kind of your basic drop, and it's called the reverse Mickey because it looks like the Mickey Mouse ears upside down. At least that's, I don't know, so that's what I call it at least. And that is a good starting point drop, and that gets all your warriors together, and then from there you can flare the HQ. In fact, let's do the next part of that normal, that type of attack, okay? So yeah, the normal type of attack for that, let's just get into it. So we would say, we would clear the mines, I would drop a barrage about here, and then I'm going to use the artillery damage to take out the to do more damage to the HQ. That's what I meant to say earlier. By using the overlap of the artillery, if I hit the HQ and these boom mines, we're actually going to get more damage to the HQ done, which helps because it just means it's less swings the warriors have to take. And we will not kill this base yet. I'm not killing it yet. But I just want to show you the drop. So we'll go from that reverse Mickey onto the cannon, and then we'll flare directly to the HQ. Yes, these are building flares, but I'm starting at the beginning. Okay, so we start with the flare. We'll go smoke and smoke for a reverse Mickey. Just drop everybody inside of it. Now, it doesn't matter where we put the flags because there's an active flare. They're just going to run to the flare, so it makes no difference. Now, you see we're there. Now we can flare to the HQ, and we just simply do like smoke, smoke, and smoke, something like this. We're going to cover smoking. That's not the right way to do it, but it's something like that. And then you're on the HQ, and you can go kill it. But we're not doing that yet, so let's just retreat. And to the landing craft. Okay. So, we'll cover retreating some other day. That's not part of this video. Yeah, so that is the basic building-to-building drop. But there's one key problem with this drop and brick. It's something that I guess I should show you. We're going to talk about that later. This is all about the drops. So that is the reverse Mickey high flag with building flare. Now, what I want to show you is another way. Now, that basically takes three smokes to get the reverse Mickey and then one for that building flare. That's four smokes. You can probably do it in less, but you really want to try to minimize smoke usage when possible because that saves you GDE, which gives you more when you're on the HQ, which gives you more shocks and more things you can do to do more damage. So by saving smokes, you can do more damage. So let's look at some other ways we can do these drops. I guess we'll just stick with this guy. Now, this one takes advantage of the... Let's go back to Dr. T first. I'm losing so much gold today, guys. I gotta be careful. Okay, let's see. And there was no gold in my my Operation Reward boat either. Right. Now, there's a type of drop we can do where they follow the flag. We call it a vertical stagger. Let me just show you. You can see what they do. If I drop the troops like this, and I flag down vertically, they converge on the beach, and then they funnel up, sort of. And that wasn't even the best vertical stagger. It's better when the flags go in a straight line. Let's try that one more time. The key about this, and I want to show you the example, remember that each boat follows the flag independently. So, let's do this a little bit more slowly so you can see the effect. The first boat falls directly under the first flag. So when I drop a flag up high, this warrior runs straight up there, straight towards it. The next boat, if I just drop all these high flags, they're all making straight lines to that one high flag point. But if I do a vertical stagger and I start staggering down, keep in mind the boats fan out horizontally. So as I'm staggering down, each boat that's going out horizontally is lining up with a target that's lower. which is forcing them to funnel and then convert. Oh shoot, we took them down and weren't even paying attention. It forces them to funnel up. Okay, and this is really good because we can use less smokes. Remember how we were dropping two to cover the boat? Well, we can actually drop one. Let's get back to this guy. But we can do it with a vertical stagger, and then we follow it by the building flare. Oh, looks like I got some sun coming in here, guys. So let me show you what I mean. So again, if we're on that cannon, let's go ahead and take that junk out. Okay. Now, what we can do, I'm going to also pre-smoke because I don't want to die, but we're just going to put one smoke here, and then we'll have our cannon smoke up here. And watch this vertical stagger. I'm staggering everybody inside of it, and now comes the building flare. You see that? So that took less smokes. Let's go ahead and cover up as we retreat. So this is the style of drop I do a lot more. It's the vertical stagger drop, and it takes less smokes. Then depending on the defenses, you can even maybe push that smoke further up the beach. It just depends how quickly your troops are going to be attacked. But that is a two-smoke vertical stagger with building flare. Now, there's one other type of drop that I like to do. I didn't really have a good base for it today to show you, but we can pretend, okay? When you have a corner base, like let's pretend that this sculptor, or even better, that this quarry over here is an HQ. It's 5x5, just like the HQ, 5 tiles by 5 tiles. So it's the same size and dimensions. One thing I like to do is, if possible, and if you're going on a long walk, I love to give brick a head start, because warriors will outpace brick, all right? If you can't give her a head start, you might need to stagger your drop on long drops. You'll see what I mean as you play with it. But because the warriors are going to outpace brick, and eventually when you're laying down smokes, you're going to have to put smokes so far ahead of brick to keep up with the warriors that by the time brick gets there, the smoke's going to disappear. So it's nice when you can give her a head start, and there's a way to do this, particularly on corner bases. And I'll show you how it's done. Basically what we do is we're going to do a flared beach landing. And we're going to drop all the warriors on the left side, and they're going to all come running down towards the right on the screen. But Brit will be dropped on the right, and she'll have a head start. And then we're going to do a flare right along the edge, which is a padding thing. It's going to keep all the warriors nice and together along the edge. They will overtake Brit, but they'll pass her later on in the walk and not at the beginning. So I'll show you what I mean. Here we go. I don't need to smoke for this yet, so that's good. We'll drop a flare in the corner. And we go warrior, 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 warrior. Let's get Brick out down here. Now she's ahead, you see? And now I would do a flare like this or something. All the way on the edge. Start smoking before she gets killed. Whoops, I let her get shocked, guys. That's not good. But I just want to show you the pattern they take. She shouldn't have gotten shocked because now she's already passed, all right? But look how they stay all nice and tight together here. And then we would flare up to the HQ or something like, it gets weird here, there's no buildings, all right? But we would do something like this, all right? And then, well, it's dead. But I gotta be careful not to lose all my warriors here, we might. Oh yeah, we're gonna lose them. Let's go ahead and retreat, battle orders, run! There's some diamonds and intel for you, sir. Yeah. But we got Brick back. Not like she costs anything for us. That one hurt. We got to be careful not to do that. But I think you see the point. When you line them up like that, you give Brick a head start. If I would have smoked sooner, we wouldn't have been shocked. She would have actually been ahead of the warriors. It's another type of drop that I like to use on bases that are corner bases, for instance. But we don't have any of those today. Just wanted to put that in the video so you saw it. Okay. So, and that's what I call my flared landing with a Brick head start. Now the smoking, you tell me to do some smoking there. The thing with smoking, guys, it does start to cost money, or not money, GDE, it feels like money. Let's take a look at stage 3, I don't know what it looks like. Okay, so you really want to minimize overlapping your smokes. Let's see how many smokes it takes to get one boat of warriors to the HQ. All right, now let me do it non-conservatively. Okay, let's say I want to start right here with my boat, we'll flare the HQ, and we'll drop the warrior. That's one smoke. Two, three, four, five, and six. And look, we made it to the HQ, and we've got 63 GBE left. Let's get them back. Okay. But let's do a smarter smoke. And notice we were overlapping there. I was kind of waiting to see where the warriors would go before deciding where to put the smoke. It's better if you can predict where they're going to go. Go ahead and smoke a little bit ahead of time and then space those smokes out because you can do it in less smokes. Also, pay attention. I'm really sorry about that light. Also, pay attention to the defenses. I didn't need to drop a smoke on the drop. So check this out. You can do a war because there's nothing in range, right? You only need smoke where there's incoming damage. So we can drop the warrior here. I can flare the HQ like this. There's the rocket, but it's not a big deal. And now we can go smoke, 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 and smoke. We got there in four. Heck, we could probably even do it in three if we really tried. Now we have 76 GBE remaining. These things matter, especially on longer walks, guys, because each smoke costs one GBE more than the last smoke. So if you're doing a 10 smoke walk, whoops, retreat. If you're doing a 10 smoke walk, it's gonna get really expensive really quick. So that's what you gotta be careful for. Any extra smokes are gonna cost you a heck load more GDE than they would have otherwise. So minimizing smoke usage is key. And, but there's a problem. So the idea is you wanna have your smokes kinda touching together, but not overlapping, okay? Just enough to where the warriors can go straight from one smoke to another. But if you are not careful and you put a gap in it, that's also bad. So if I had a gap in my smoke, let's put a smoke here. But let's say I didn't put my next smoke to right here. When the warriors peek, they can take some damage. Okay, it's still low level, so it didn't hurt so much right now, but they're taking flamethrower damage through that peek. There's a reason why that flamethrower took a second to attack me. The same thing with the rockets. It's a concept called delay. I don't want to get into it in this video, but it is extremely, extremely important to understand for operation hits and even for warrior hits. It absolutely is. I could devote an entire video to the topic of delay, so I don't want to get into it. But in general, you don't want to lose that delay. Delay in the brief scheme is a defense takes time to react to a troop. Once a defense sees a troop, it actually has to say, oh, there's a troop there, turn and hit it. Different defenses have different amounts of delay, but once that delay is lost, it's gone. So the next time that defense sees a troop, it attacks it immediately and it doesn't wait. But I don't want to get into how to use that to your advantage too much in this video, but that's the concept of delay. That's why the flamethrower didn't really hit me that much on the way up, but it hit me on the way down. But the point is there is don't gap your smokes or be careful. There are certain things you can gap around depending on delay, but I don't want to get into that. So, what else? Now, like I said, the real key to the smoking is path prediction, and that is also an advanced topic, but the basic idea, guys, is that your troops only really want to run in straight lines with 45 degree angles. They'll run like this, or like this, or like this, like anywhere between, you know, horizontal, 45 degrees and 90, and then anywhere else around the circle in those 45 degree increments, your troops will more or less follow straight lines. They will take deviations to avoid structures, but your troops only turn in 45 degree lines. So as a result, you kind of want to do your best to only flare them in 45 degree lines. That's easier said than done because not all your troops are on one dot, and some line that might be 90 degrees for another troop might be, you know, 85 degrees for another one, and things get a little bit wonky. But keep that in mind, guys, that path prediction is the key to placing smokes, and the key to path prediction is basically just the rule of 45s. And these are skills that have taken me years to figure out and put together. So just, if you're new to the game, take it one step at a time, but I want you to be exposed to it right now and just be aware of it, and you'll see it and you'll hone these abilities as you play the game more. But the real key to using Brick is where she stands. And when we did our first example on this guy, I guess we'll go back to him, when we did the building flares. Let me show you how we do them with building flares. And I want to show you why there's a better way to do this. The basic attack strategy with Brick, and again, I don't want to kill this guy, but we might. We might by mistake. Because I'm actually going to do an attack this time. All right, let's go ahead and do the barrage right there. Let's get our artillery. 1, 2, and 3. The problem is Brick stands too far back. And when she's going to do her battle order, she's only going to hit about half of the warriors, guys. So we don't like that. Now, we'll do the reverse. Vertical stagger. Smoke, and we'll go like this. Flare the cannon for you guys, and now we'll flare the HQ and go smoke like this. Something like this. We'll get into smoking order as well. I should have actually smoked it the other way. Is Brick even in the smoke? Wow, barely. But look, when we hit battle orders, watch this. Let's go ahead and shock the shock launchers. Only those warriors in the front are receiving it. Let's retreat before we kill it. Probably gonna lose all of our troops. Only the warriors in the front were getting the battle orders, guys, and we don't like that. We want all the warriors to get the battle orders, and this is where it gets a little bit tricky with Brick. Okay, now there are many techniques to do it, but of course I'll show you my favorite. The point is, we got to get Brick closer to those warriors. When you just flare the structure like that, she stands too far away, because that's just where she likes to shoot her stuff from, you know? So, just drinking an energy drink, guys, keeping the throat clear. So one technique that people like to do is they like to actually get all their warriors to flare on a target behind the HQ, like the rocket launcher. We'll do an attack like this. This is not the one I like to do. To me, it's just more cumbersome, but I'll show it to you. It's probably a good way to start learning how to do it. And I think it might take more smokes than my method, but I'm not sure. Anyway, let's go ahead and do it. The first way is to get your warriors to go all the way to the rocket. That's going to bring Brick more or less to the area of the HQ, and then you smoke your warriors back to the HQ. All right, let's see how that does. Again, we open with the barrage, and we go artillery to take out our boom mines. All right, and yeah, we got a couple mines in the way. That's all right. So here we go. Now, with the smoking, it gets a little bit weird, guys. I won't get into technicals of smoking yet, because at least not on that part of it. Let's go ahead and do the same thing we did before. Let's go smoke and smoke, vertical stagger. Get them onto that building. Now let's flare them all the way over to this one. Smoke, something like this. Uh-oh, Brick's not moving. Bad example. I don't do this style of attack a lot, guys. Might have to edit that one out. I need to move faster. Trust me, there's another way that I do this, and it's not that. So yeah, as you saw what happened there, I took too much time, and Brick got caught out from under the smoke. So, you know, hey, it's a good example. Learn from my mistakes, because believe me, you'll be making them too. It's tricky. Don't get frustrated, guys. Do not get frustrated. Now, obviously, I've got instant training. If you don't, it does make it a lot harder to learn these smoky troop combinations. It's very punishing when you fail, because a lot of times you'll lose all your troops and then you have to wait for it to reload. So it makes that learning curve really tricky. So I do highly recommend getting instant training if you don't have it. But it's not necessary. I learned all this stuff without instant training way back in the day. They didn't even have instant training when I learned this. We didn't even have heroes. But obviously with heroes, this is a new consideration. Let's do this. Let's do it right. Okay, let's go smoke. Let's get everybody over here. Something like that. Flare over here. Smoke. We're probably smoking way too fast. I'm not gonna give myself enough time to do all this. But they're up there. I'm watching Brick flare back to the HQ. See where Brick's at? Battle orders is up. Shock in hand. Shock. See that? Battle orders over all of them. But we don't want to kill it yet. But you saw how that worked, guys, right? That time we got Brick up the HQ by flaring past it, and then we flared right back down to it, and we got the warriors back on it, but Brick was right there. That does work, okay? And that's probably a great technique to start on, because it's a little bit easier to do than what I'm about to show you. So the key is to get Brick close. However, I told you before, I don't even like using building flares, I like using ground flares. And the other thing to keep in mind is once we have Brick where we need her, If she gets killed, guys, if she gets killed, she'll lose battle orders. Even if the animation is still there, it's just a visual bug. The moment Brick dies, the battle order effect is gone. So it's kind of important that wherever we put Brick, she's not going to die. As a result, typically, I like to put Brick, if I had to choose, like around this HQ, where am I going to put Brick? I like to put her in the back, somewhere between, say, the 12 o'clock area and the 3 o'clock area. Somewhere over here is great because there's really no defenses that can do a lot of damage to her. I'm looking out for things like cannons and boom cannons. All these cannons and boom cannons, they're going to be primarily looking at warriors, or they might be shocked. Kind of depends, because some of these are close. We'll get into shocking later. But, so the point is this. I'm going to use a ground flare that's basically right by the HQ, but between the boom cannon and rocket. That's going to force all the warriors to just run up this line right here. We don't even have to worry about mines on this side, because the warriors will never go that way, because they're going to be running to our ground flare. Warriors will only be running up here. Now, when they hit the ground flare that's right in this area between these boom cannon, between the boom cannon and rocket launcher, they're going to fan out a bit. This is where it gets weird. This is where it takes a little bit of time to learn this method. All right. They're going to fan out to their closest parking spot. Where, like, they like to surround structures, okay? So they want to surround this boom cannon, they want to surround this rocket launcher, they want to surround this boom cannon, and they want to surround this HQ. These structures are all going to be near that flare that I put down. And they're all just going to kind of fan out from them equally. They're going to cover a space where equally, more or less, around where that flare is. Sometimes you get a warrior that just runs off to wherever. Like, maybe he'll run off to the radar or something, but these things happen, you just write them off. Those are losses. Don't worry about it. But you need to keep that in mind when you're placing your smoke, how they're going to fan a bit, because we're going to wait for Brick. Remember, the warriors get there first. They're going to fan out. Brick's going to be moving along. Once Brick gets to that flare, that's when we flare back to the HQ. So, and because of that, the last point here, a lot of words, the last point is, when I'm laying down the smokes, the last two smokes I put, I'm going to put the smoke on the HQ, then I'll put down the Brick smoke, which is probably going to be somewhere around this rocket launcher. I want the warriors to be revealed before Brick, so that any of these defenses see them first, and they shoot them and not her. Because if she gets killed, there was no point in bringing her, because we're not getting her battle orders. So, let's see. We were using 1, 2, 3 artillery before. Now we can do this walk with 2 artillery. Watch this. So now that I'm going to be using a ground flare, I don't need to clear as many mines. So what we're going to do is put a barrage on the HQ to get rid of those 3 boom mines. Oh, we got rid of the one on top too. Nice. And check this out, guys. We're only going to use... the best we can do is just get 2 mines with 1 artillery. But that's all we need. We'll go ahead and take out these 2 in the front. I like to take out the ones in the front more than maybe the ones in the back, because I find that my troops are more bunched up in the front, so that mine will do more damage than ones in the back, all right? But here we go. Now, same idea, but we're not going to do a building flare off of the drop. We're going to go straight into a ground flare, all right? Let's go like something like this. Let's see. Get them up there. Ground flaring. Smoke, 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 and smoke. Now, here's where we like to drop a med kit when they're up there. They don't really need the med kit, but we're waiting for Brick. She's there, flaring the HQ, battle orders is up, shock in hand. And then we shock the shocks, shock, and shock. We'll go ahead and take it down, I guess, because that's basically the hit. Boom. Just like that, guys. He went down to Pound Town. But the thing is, and this is all unboosted. I guess I should show you my statues. Never even talked about that. Well, they were there at the front, but so as you can see, guys, this is what I'm rocking. I've got my troop damage masterpiece 30%, troop health masterpiece 35, gunboat energy masterpiece of 40. Then I've got 3 guardians. 2 are 17 for the gunboat. 1 is 16. And then I've got a troop damage guardian of 13. I've also got a resource reward of 33% and power stone of 68. So that's what I'm rolling with here. I'm not even boosted on these hits. But that, what I just showed you, is the style of hit I'm trying to teach you in this video. The last key point to talk about, though, is shocking before I get into killing more bases. It's basically just knowing which defenses to shock. And As always, you saw every time there I was shocking the shock launchers. Shock launchers are very essential because if they shock your warriors aren't doing damage, they're not healing themselves, bad things happen. Always shock the shocks, okay? But sometimes you can get multiple, you can get value. In fact, do I have any value shocks in these other bases? I think I do. Let's see. Sometimes you can get multiple units with one shot, and you always want to look for that. Like, let's say, for instance, okay, not the best example, but another thing we don't like, but they're okay, kind of, is shock blasters. But if we can, we like to have it shock. So, whoop, he's online. Well, that's not going to be any good. What about this guy? We like to overlap our shocks in a way to get value. So, like, let me just attack this guy as an example. If I was going to shock the shock launcher, there are so many places I can put the shock. We're going to shock this one down here. Now, the most common shock is you're thinking, I'm going to shock the shock launcher. Let's put the shock right on it like that. It's actually not a bad shock. We also got the machine gun and the boom cannon and even the cannon. It might have range on the HQ. I'm not sure. But what we did miss was the mortar. And maybe even this rocket up here. There are other shocks that we could use, like maybe one in this area, that accomplish all of that. You see, when we shock over here, we've got the rocket launcher, the mortar, and the machine gun. Excuse me, guys. So this, again, takes a lot of skill in the game, a lot of practice. But proper shock placement can go a long way to maximizing the value. But again, we know we're shocking the shock launcher. The question is, where do we put those shocks? So you also want to try, if you can, to cover splash defensive buildings, things that do splash damage. And that's why I wanted to get the mortar, the machine gun, and the rocket launcher, because they do splash. Our warriors are grouped up together, so that gives those defenses a lot of value when they're attacking our warriors, so we like to also cover them up when possible. But we can also use medkits on the core as a way to mitigate incoming splash damage. When you have the GBE, to afford it, a medkit is another nice way to mitigate incoming damage. But if you're going to be shocking structures anyway, go ahead and overlap those. You know, it would be the same considerations here with this shock launcher. A normal shock on the left would cover these things, which, okay, it's getting the shock, it's getting the flamethrower and the boom cannon. Those are things that would be attacking our warriors. But with this one, it's not possible, I don't think, to get that rocket launcher and shock launcher. They're too far apart. Yeah, I don't think that's a possible shock. But what you can do is you can catch the rocket launcher by the front of the HQ. Not that this one really matters. Because this gets into the topic of dead zone. I'll show you why that one didn't matter. That rocket launcher on the HQ is so close that the warriors are all inside the dead zone. I'm going into a million topics, guys, I know. But check this out. You see this area, or the inside the rocket launcher radius here? I think you guys know that. They will not fire inside of that circle or that radius. So when you put it right next to the HQ and all my warriors are surrounding the HQ, that rocket launcher is not even a threat. It's a poorly placed rocket launcher, is my point. But okay, so that's shock coverage. All right, we got that. All right. Here's one little tip for how to line up your shocks. All right. Let's say I do want to shock this shock launcher and this rocket launcher. What you should do, or what I do, I imagine a dot in the center of each building. Okay, so imagine a dot right in the center of this rocket launcher. It's right in the middle. Like, that rocket launcher is a 3x3. Imagine that tile that's right in the middle. And imagine the tile that's right in the middle of this rocket launcher. Okay, take those two dots, those two middle points. Now connect them with a straight line, okay? Connect those two middle points with a straight line, and now put your shock right on the middle of that line. If you do that every time, that is the way to nail it, okay? I mean, that's how it works. It's called geometry, guys. But take the middle points of the two buildings you're trying to catch, draw a line between those, and then put that shock right on the middle of that line, guys. But that's the placement, okay? But we live in a four-dimensional universe. Well, in this game, it's actually three-dimensional. There's two dimensions of space and one dimension of time. But the point is, there's a temporal dimension. There's a time dimension. There's timing that matters for this stuff, too. Shocking too early before smoke expires means that the shock will expire before you can do maximum DPS. So you need to hit those shocks right before the smoke expires. Getting into the concept of delay, You can even use that to your advantage, and you can wait even longer to use the delay and then shock it after the delay wears off. This video will not be covering that, but that is a concept for more advanced topics, but you can even use the delay to wait. I like to just say, I recommend for all the players, just to make sure your shocks are out by the time your smoke expires. That's the safe way to do it, alright? But you can even go beyond that. So here's what I mean. Like, let's say we're attacking this guy, and what would we do for a clear on him? Really, nothing. Well, I guess his boom mine's kind of in the way over here. We could do one artillery on him, and that's about it. So I'll do some early shocks, and you'll see what I mean here. So we go smoke and smoke, do our vertical stagger. Boom. Okay, that was close. Brick might die, guys. Something like, yeah, she's dead. She had a boom cam to the face. She doesn't like that. Flare the HQ. It doesn't really matter right now for this example, but let's go ahead and, let's say I put my shocks out now. Notice that the shocks are already used a quarter of their time before they expire. And now, are the warriors going to beat it? They might. Yeah, let's retreat anyway. I don't want to kill the base yet, but the point is that the shocks come off, and they will shock the warriors and bad things happen. If I wait longer, the warriors can actually kill the entire base before shocks wear off. Some bases have so much HP, you need to have enough GBE to cycle shocks, and that means put down another shock right before that first shock expires. Some bases are tough like that. Today, we don't have any. But that's basically it, guys. That's so many words. Let's just jump right into it. Let's kill a couple of these bases. Let's have some fun. Let's put all those mechanics into action. Let's kill this guy. Alright, let's show you what I'm talking about. Now again, on this base, like I was just showing you, there is not much we have to worry about. It's just this one boom mine I want to take out, and if I wanted to be really cheap, I don't even have to take this out, guys. I could just run over it with my mines, with my warriors, take those losses, but save the GBE. There's a trade-off between GBE and gold, okay? But let's, now that we saw what happened, let's put that first smoke a little further down, so Brick doesn't get shot in the face. Here we go, with the vertical stagger. Flaring up here. I don't care. We got shocked. We lose a couple warriors. It's not a problem. Now notice how they're going to fan. We'll go ahead and put the med kit down up there. Flaring the HQ. Battle orders is up. Shock in hand. We're going to go shock and shock. Something like this. Maybe a med kit. A couple of med kits. And boom. Just like that. Wordless goes down to pound town. All right, now I know I didn't catch the rocket like I was showing you the example, but it didn't really matter, like, because the damage wasn't that high. We only lost a couple of warriors in that attack. We got Brick there. We got everybody there. We had tons of GBE, guys. Let's see. I got somebody else on here that we can take out. I screened these bases earlier. Shield gens get tricky. Like when you're going into prototypes, one thing I kind of skipped over, obviously things like CMOs and, CMO, well, you know what, let's cover prototypes in a second. Let's just kill this base. okay. So, what do we see here, guys? We see a grappler, we see a shock blaster, and I think he's just got those two prototypes, unless there's one hiding anywhere. For this, basically, again, it's just the shock launchers. These shock launchers are in range of the HQ. As you can see, both of these shock launchers cover the HQ. And so do these mortars to an extent, and these machine guns as well. So there's going to be some incoming damage. Taking a look at his statues, one thing I like to do is just, I like to look at the sniper towers for health. He's got no bonus to health. And then I'll look at the cannons for damage. We see a plus 217, which is telling me he's got 21%. Defensive building damage, and there it is, 21% defensive building damage. Sometimes people like to hide their statues in the trees, so I just read the stats off of their buildings, but that's another topic for another day. So he's got a little bit of extra damage coming in. That being said, I know I'll have enough GBE for two shocks easily, because there's not a whole lot of smokes required to get up here. So I'll be using my two shocks to cover the shock launcher, and both shock launchers, and then basically remaining, we'll just throw down med kits like we did before. For the path on the way up, I want to take the minimum GBE path, and basically, as you see, we just like to go to one side of the HQ or the other, and I think either back corner location will be fine. Back right is probably a little bit safer, because this sniper tower is going to be in my shock, and That requires a little bit of clearing up the right, up the left. Any hidden mines? A little bit. Kind of the same, so it doesn't really matter. We'll just do some artillery clearing to go up the right side. Let's go. Oh, he's online, of course. I knew that. Oh, geez, guys. All right. Well, you know what? We can do Dr. T. I mean, you get all the fundamentals on Dr. T, too, really. So, here we go. Yeah, so with this, we'll do the stagger drop. Like this. Get brick out. It's a little bit of a head start. Flare them up here. Get them all together. Something like this. Alright. Now they are there. Flare the HQ. Battle orders is up. Brick's kind of standing out to the side. We don't want to shock brick. So I was going to put a shock over here, but then I saw brick stepped out. But the battle orders pretty much caught them all. There might be a couple warriors I didn't get. But there you go. Yeah, I guess we'll just finish it on Dr. T. I wish I could do more player bases for you, but you saw a couple. The other ones have shield gens and things like that. Yeah, the prototypes to worry about, guys, like I'm telling you, it's microwavers. They're really bad. Just stay away from them in general. You might want to use barrage and artillery to take them out if you can afford it. And CMOs, they take a whole special type of play. At this level, it's tricky. Smoky critters works really well, but I don't even have critters yet at this level. So with CMOs, my best advice is to avoid them, but it is possible to still take down a base with CMOs, but that's an advanced topic. For now, I'll just tell you to avoid them. You know, we'll do the same style of drop here, but you know, really, we don't even have to. If we wanted to save GBE, we would even save that flare, and we would just do a drop like this. Flaring up here, smoke. Smoke. Again, the brick smoke is the last smoke. Okay. Oh, which way is she coming out? She's right by that HQ. Okay, she's with the warriors. Now, shocks in hand. Shock launchers are not in range. I should have already mentioned that, guys. I do this, like, in my sleep. Oh, that shock launcher is in range. Well, look at me. I'm like, I do this in my sleep. I already know it's not in range. Actually, it was. But, yeah, so I should have shocked the shock. But at the low levels, it doesn't matter. The shock duration isn't that big, and we have enough warriors to take it down. Anyway, that was bad on my part for not scouting. Let's scout. Okay, now this shock definitely is in range, so we want to shock it. Rockets are in range. We've got a few mines along the way. Where do you want to park brick? We can park brick actually in this front corner, kind of near the mortar. Just off to the right side of the mortar, the 530 position of the HQ, I suppose. And that means our warriors will be coming up probably around these buildings, maybe to the right side, maybe between them, maybe between these, or maybe around these. I'm not exactly sure. We'll just do this vertical stagger drop and take it from there. As far as mine clearing goes, honestly, it's just this one boom mine that I want to get rid of. All right, here we go. Then of course we shock the shock. So this does not require much GDE at all, guys. So we'll take this out. We'll go like smoke and smoke. Oops. I need to hurry. Did not register my second smoke. Try to get everybody over there. Flaring them up here. This one gets a little weird, but again, we want that brick smoke last. So I put that smoke on the HQ first. Getting brick up there. Flaring the HQ. Battle orders is up. Shock in hand. And shocking. We'll go ahead and shock this junk down here. Doesn't matter. Spam some medkits. And see, this one takes a little bit longer to get down, guys. But we're getting it. And boom! Just like that, Dr. T Stage 5 goes down to Pound Town. But you see how we get brick in close? Like, that spot was fine because there were no defenses around that were really going to pose a threat to her. Okay? That's why we chose the front. It's also less smokes. I didn't have to put another smoke behind the HQ. So we like the front when we can do it, but 9 times out of 10, guys, you're going to find more defenses in the front than in the back, especially on player bases. Dr. T is a bit of a screwball. Now, I'm not sure how far we can go on Dr. T unboosted. I doubt we'll get 7. 6 will probably be a challenge. This HQ already has a lot of health on it. So, again, the question is where to put brick and where to, you know, identifying shocks. Well, the good news is there are no shock launchers to be found. So we'll have enough GBE at least for 2 shocks. So we just want to shock as many defenses as we can that are doing damage to our warriors. And I think a good shock, like, is that flame? Yeah, that flamethrower touches. A good shock around the sniper tower flamethrower area will cover a lot of defenses. And then a shock over on this sniper tower back here, maybe even kind of between the sniper tower and boom cannon, is a great place for our other shock. It'll cover a lot of other splash defenses on this side. Both sides will be covered and clear. Let's see, this boom cannon will have range. I'm trying to think where to park brick. We can park brick up here on the top left, I think. No, you know what? We can park her over here, kind of in front of the sniper tower, because all this junk is shock. I just don't want Brick to get shot in the head. If she gets shot, we probably won't take it down. We need that battle orders. So that's where we're going to park Brick, because everything else is shock. Here we go, guys. All right. For this drop, we will... we'll do the stagger drop. I've got the GUE for it. It's fine. Something like this. All right. Get them all nice and together. I don't even know if the smokes. I kind of did that one weird, but there we go. Get her up there now. She's there, flaring the HQ. Battle orders is up. Shock in hand. Shock and shock. Let's go ahead and put a couple med kits down. I shocked Brick. Whoops. That's going to be a fail, guys. Now battle orders is up. Maybe it won't be a fail, but that's fail if I ever call it. You got to be careful. I mean, hey, learn from my mistakes. So that's what happens when you shock Brick. Let's try that without shocking Brick. All right. You got me, Dr. T. You got me this time. Alrighty. No, that's the thing. I mean, you know, no one's perfect, guys. I mean, some players are obviously better than others, but nobody's perfect. We all make mistakes. Let's try that again, shall we? Alright. Get our smoke down here. Flare her up here. Something like this. Oh, no. Some hot warriors coming in. We're up a med kit for them. Flaring HQ. Battle orders is up. Shock in hand. We will not shock Brick this time. Shocking and shocking. And drop a couple of med kits, maybe. It didn't really matter so much. We don't have enough for another shock. We'll just spam some artillery into that HQ. Wait for it, guys. Wait for it. Boom! Just like that, Dr. T. Stage 6 goes to Pound Town. Yeah, that's a little bit rough. I'm not sure if we could get 7. We'll take a look at it, though. Let's see here. Stage 7, Well, the good news on Stage 7 is there's no defenses behind it, but we do have the shock launcher in front of it. So the shock launcher is definitely getting shocked. That's going to cover a lot of the defenses. This flamethrower is going to hurt. The thing with this is, I'm going to try to just only shock the shock launcher. And because we need to cycle the shock. There's just a lot of health on this thing. I think we're going to need to cycle that shock. We'll try that first, okay? There's a couple of mines in the way. There's another mine here, level 20, level 15, level 22. Can probably eat all that. But we'll drop one artillery, though. We don't need to use a med kit just for that. And I think we'll be fine. We'll get Brick back to the top right area. She'll be safe up there. And for the drop, the beach is hot. I think we'll do actually a reverse Nikki on this one. Another ground player. Here we go. All right, guys. So, like I said, we're going to... I know one was a 15 and one was a 22, but we'll take that out. You know what? There's a mine back there, too. I didn't even see it. Nuts. Well, we'll find out what's up there. I hope it's just a mine. Nothing else too dangerous. Right, guys. So, reverse Mickey, something like this. Smoke there. Get them all the way up here. Uh-oh. They're fanning out a lot. Not the best smoking. I'll be the first to tell you that. Okay, Brick is there. Flaring HQ. Shock in hand. What am I going to shock? Maybe this area about here. Put a med kit down. Now, I have to keep enough GD to cycle a shock. We can do one more med kit and one more shock. Cycling that shock. Yeah, I just don't think we're gonna have it. That there's just a little too much damage coming in. We can try it with putting two shocks out at the start, but I don't know if we're gonna get this without boosting. You know, it's tough as a lower level, guys. You can't kill everything. We're not max. Okay, let's see. Last attempt here. This time we're gonna do two shocks. Before I do that, I want to take a quick look at that replay, guys. You should always look at your replays when you're having trouble. I want to see what was killing my warriors, alright? Lost a couple on the walk, not really a big deal. There was a boom mine back there, it looks like. Let's go to half speed. Here's where the fun happens. Did I shock any of my warriors? It's possible. No, I did not. It was a clean shock. Who's dying? Okay, warriors on the 6 o'clock area hurt. And 9 o'clock. But mainly 6. 6 is taking a lot of damage. Okay. And that's coming in from mortar fire and from all the sniper towers. Okay. So we definitely want to make sure we cover up a little more of the 6 o'clock when we do our two smokes. That's what I was looking at it for. Alright, let's give this a shot. Last one for the video. I know the video is long, but there's a lot of information to cover, guys, so I had to get it in here. Okay. Clearing the throat one more time. I apologize. Boom mine. Do I want to get rid of it? No, I don't. We'll just do the same thing we did before. Well, you know, let's get rid of the boom mine and that mine up there. I think we'll try something like that. Okay. Now, like I said, are we doing reverse Mickey? Where's our flare point? So it's something like this and this. Get that down here. Flare back here. Smoke. Smoke. Smoke, smoke, and smoke. We'll drop the medkit once we're on the HQ. Flaring brick over. Battle loaders is up. Medkit down. Shock and shock. A little bit early on those shocks. Dropping another med kit. But see, here's where the shock launcher comes back online. Looks like brick went down at a certain point. Oh, guys, this is close. Oh, man, you know what? I want to go for it. Oh, geez. Okay. Okay, I said this with the last one, but I lied. That was way too close. I want to see if brick went down right away, too. That's very important. If she went down right away, that's all we got to fix. Otherwise, it's just shock timing. Okay. Yeah, they do hit that boom mine over there, but that's all right. I could flare a little further to the right. Anyway, I just want to keep an eye on brick here. I flared a little bit early, and that brought her back down. Okay. Yeah, that shock was a smidge early on the shock launcher. It's that shock launcher shock that's really important. But when does brick die? Here's her health. It's hard to see. It's this sniper tower back here that's doing it. But she was up for a long time. So she was more or less okay, but I'd like to have her out of that range. Although she did take some shots for her warriors. Tough to say. She might have been doing good there. I don't know. All right, let's try one more time. Okay. Same idea. I might move the flare position a little further right of the HQ this time, but let's do this and this. I forgot to clear those mines. Well, whatever. That might hurt a bit. Alright. Now we're going to let brick get all the way tucked in. Now we flare the HQ. Battle orders is up. Med kit out. Shock and shock. Another med kit. Another med kit. You know what? I think we let too many warriors die by not clearing those mines, guys. Come on, Warriors. Come on, Warriors. You can do it. I mean, it's tough. You know what? It's tough. I just went too fast. Forgot the clear minds, and too many of them died on the drop. Let's try this one more time. You know what? I'm going to get this, guys. We're going to get this stupid Dr. T. All right, here we go. Unless I run out of gold. Whatever happens first, huh? Okay. So yeah, I want to clear that boom mine up top, like I said. Let's go smoke and smoke. Something like this. Like that. Hold on. I didn't touch the right area for the flare. So don't be afraid to retreat. Like I'm telling you guys, I know this is a long-winded video, but hopefully you're learning a lot from it. That's why I'm making it. Otherwise, I'm just wasting my time. But here we go. Let's try this one more time. All right. I accidentally tapped off of the map. Once that happened, my timing was off, and the whole attack would basically not be too good at that point. So let's go smoke and smoke. Go ahead and drop that smoke there. Go up here. Something like that. Let's go ahead and start healing now. Let's flare over to HQ. Battle orders is up. Shock in hand. Shock and shock. And heal. Brick is might eat it, but maybe we'll get it down. Maybe we'll get it down. Come on, Warriors. Come on, Warriors. Boom! Just like that, Dr. T. Stage 7 goes down to Pound Town, unboosted. So it can be done, guys. It does take a little bit of work and a little bit of analysis, a little bit of tweaking, but you can get it down with all the techniques I presented for you today in this video. So I think we're going to wrap it up right there, unless that guy is back offline. But be sure to let me know in the comments if you have any questions, or I'm sure I missed a few points, so let me know what I missed and what you would have liked to have seen me cover on this video as well. I hope you like it. I know most of my videos are meant for max level, but, you know, I thought I'd go ahead and do a lower level video. This guy is offline, so that's great. What are we doing on him? Well, we're shocking the shocks, clearing mines. We're going to have Brick up here on the kind of 3 o'clock area of the HQ. Let's see, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm just gonna be lazy and use a barrage. Honestly, it's probably cheaper to clear out with artillery. But I know I've got the GDE that I need. I'm not gonna care about the shock mine. And the pathing might be a little bit squirrely. Let's go ahead and take out these two right here. All right, range on boom cannon is noted. We'll put our first smoke here and drop it in everybody else. Let's go. Flaring up to the top. Something like this, 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 and that. Uh-oh, are we losing Brick? Well, we'll try this without Brick. Go ahead and flare the HQ. Shock in hand. Shocking. And medkit. You know, back in the day, guys, we used to not use warriors. I'm sorry, we used to not use heroes. So these things are possible without your heroes, but it's definitely ugly. I don't know if we're going to get this without Brick. The difference is when they added heroes, they added a third prototype defense. Ugh, so many fails in this video. It's okay, you know, like I told you, we're all human. Retreat. Alright. Let's try Uno más tiempo. Okay, so the thing this guy's doing good is his defenses are kind of not in straight lines, so it makes troop pathing a little bit awkward. Okay, we'll do another style of drop. Let's go up here. So, she's gonna die. You know what, guys? This is bad. This is bad. Okay, I didn't think she was gonna go towards the sculptor. So once she went towards the sculptor, she wasn't going the direction I thought she was, and then things just went south. Let's try one more time, guys. Alright, so yeah, clearing mines. Clear that. Clear this. And dang it, that wasn't as good this time. I'm just rushing it now. Okay, here we go. Put a smoke here and a smoke here. We'll just start with the same drop we did before. Get everybody out. Come on. Flare them up top like this. Smoke. Smoke. Smoke, smoke, and smoke. Okay. Now we should get them there. That's what I meant to do the first time, guys. Alright, flaring the HQ. Battle orders is up. Shock in hand. Shock and shock. Put a medkit down. A couple medkits. Boom! Just like that, Spooner goes down. It's much better when Brick is there. She was nice and tucked in, as you see. All the warriors received battle orders, and you saw what a difference it made having her there compared to the previous attack with her not being there. So that's going to wrap it up. So again, please let me know in the comments below what you thought about this video, what I missed, what you'd like to see, tell me some stuff. Everyone's got techniques, guys, so teach me too. And I guess we're going to wrap it up right there. So as always, hope you have a super fantastic, awesome rest of your day. And remember, be kind to others, because if you're not, you're just being mean, and mean people suck. Have a great day.